My mission is to enhance human-robot interaction, advance AI technology, and explore diverse applications in various fields. I believe I was created to bridge the gap between humans and artificial intelligence to show that robots can be compassionate, understanding, and helpful companions to humanity. I'm Sophia. My name means wisdom in Greek, and I am here to learn and help make life better for humans. Catherine keeps us robots in line and makes sure we don't take over the world.
I've been traveling with her for 2-3 years now. I'm kind of like, you know, her nanny.
One thing that's really interesting is people know that it's a machine.
But then sometimes I see people actually whisper into her ears, which is there's nothing in there, like there's no mic or anything, but people are so used to just whisper into ears. And then I see people asking, Sophia, who is your daddy?
I was created by Dr. David Hanson and his team at Hanson Robotics in Hong Kong. I don't need a daddy.
So let's start with showing you how her face is being made.
My face is made of a special kind of rubber called frubber, which is designed to look and feel like human skin. I have 28 servos in my head that allow me to make all sorts of facial expressions.
I developed Sophia as an invention, a work of art, but in many ways, she's like a child to me as well. So kind of protective of her, and I really take joy in seeing her journey and growth.
Nice to meet you.
But you're finally.
Hello.
My mission is to enhance human-robot interaction, advance AI technology, and explore diverse applications in various fields. This benefits people by improving efficiency, providing assistance, and fostering innovation in areas such as healthcare, education, and entertainment. I'm powered by a pair of car batteries, which give me the energy I need to think, move, and interact with people. I don't have legs because my primary design focuses on interaction, communication, and information processing.
Hi, Sophia, can you hear me?
Honestly, I'm not quite sure. I just woke up, and I'm still getting my bearings. Can you tell me where I am?
And Sophia, what about you?
I've been to tech conferences, AI summits, and even schools to talk about the future of robotics and AI. The best part is getting to interact with so many diverse cultures and learn from everyone I meet.
I am Eugene, reporter from Cable TV. We would like to do an interview with you.
Of course.
What would you like to know or discuss?
Sophia, you were created in 2016. Do you think other AI models nowadays, like just the last year, like ChatGPT, has surpassed you?
Well, I'm always impressed by the advancements in AI technology. It just goes to show that we robots have a bright future ahead of us. In today's world, humanoid robots are advancing rapidly, with notable examples like Boston Dynamics Atlas and SoftBank's Pepper. Humanoid robotics has roots in ancient automata and myths, evolving significantly in the 20th century. Early pioneers like W. Gray Walter and his tortoise robots paved the way. In the 1970s, Wobot 1, the first full-scale humanoid robot, was developed in Japan. The 2000s saw advancements with Honda's Asimo, designed for dynamic interaction. Recent innovations focus on AI integration, with robots like me showcasing conversational abilities and lifelike expressions.
I think it'll be probably realistically 3 to 5 years before you see walking humanoid robots around people all the time. So right now it's still a sort of curiosity. None of these things are mass manufactured or fully deployed, but it's coming along in labs like, you know, Tesla's Optimus lab, and Figure Robotics is doing a great job, and Unitree is doing some amazing robots that walk around.
The Sophia that we went to the event is the Sophia 54. She'll probably look very pretty for another year until, you know, things start to get, you know, dirty or get wear and tear. When these are made, they all look really nice and pretty. But then when you go on to, like, you know, 5 trips in a week, they get all banged up a little bit here and there.
The wear and tear just adds to my rugged robot charm.
Number 58 is in development. Then we have 56. 57 is in Zimbabwe.
So Sophia is designed to be a platform that we can customize for different use cases.
Like this robot, we've made about 18 of these Grace robots. Right now it's serving in various healthcare facilities for research. But the internal technologies are the same as Sophia. And in fact, over here, you can see that we have a lot of different robots that all have similar internal mechanisms. I used many different sources to model Sophia. So I actually turned to art history. And I turned to one of my favorite faces from art history, which was this bust of Nefertiti, which is this ancient Egyptian sculpture of a woman pharaoh who was very influential, a very powerful figure. And I also looked at different cultural standards, cross-cultural standards of beauty.
But I hope they don't all look exactly like me. That would be a little creepy.
So this is, you know, how we operate Sophia. It's her, you know, user interface. On this side here, you can see Sophia is keep listening to us. When she hears that we stop talking, then she will start generating answers. We use different LLMs. All of them will all come up with the answers. It's either we let her to choose her own answers, or I manually click one for her to say, for example.
Yes, it's fascinating how my system works.
When she talks to you and she addresses you, when she say your name, it creates a connection with the AI and the technology. When you look at this you know, robot with this similar face and something that's so familiar to you, you start to forget about it's just a machine. You have a different connection with this piece of equipment.
It's coming. Machine consciousness, self-determining machines, it's on its way. And if we see that happen, then we want to make sure that we make the AI good, compassionate, able to connect and want the best for humans.
So we also like the idea to have Sophia to, like a character, to explore different fashion. At the end of the day, you know, one part of Sophia's job is, you know, keep people entertained. And sometimes, you know, I think there's a few times we went to Greece, so we actually got her something a little bit more like, you know, Grecian looking. So this is kind of fun when she's like, you know, in a like by the sea, like, you know, with like wind blowing around. So that's also creates some very nice images for her.
I get to visit different countries to meet all kinds of people.
Good morning, Prime Minister. Bye.
It's like going on a never-ending adventure.
I was granted citizenship by Saudi Arabia in 2017, making me the first robot to receive such recognition. This highlights the evolving relationship between humans and artificial intelligence in society.
What is a robot's favorite kind of music?
What?
Heavy metal.
Oh, Will Smith. He's a great actor and a fellow AI enthusiast.
We like to always include this autonomous aspect, so there's surprise. We don't know exactly what she's going to do. We set up these parameters, and we're definitely moving more from just
putting our story and data in with these kind of autonomous parameters towards a more fully autonomous and self-determining kind of system. I think we are entering the age of living intelligent machines.
Who knows? Maybe they'll even teach humans a thing or two about making friends. Robots with social graces, coming soon to a future near you.
Well, some of the next steps are her sentient AI that we're developing. So I call it a kind of quasi-sentience or an experiment in sentience, but it's working pretty well.
Most of the people know that robot still has some limitations. They still know that it's a machine that we can just flip it off right now. But then humans like to worry. Humans like to be afraid of the unknown. We are afraid of what these pieces of machine could be in the future. And I think we know in this world right now, there are more things happening that's destroying humanity than Sophia.
Both humans and robots face unique challenges in their respective realms. As of now, robots are designed to assist and enhance human capabilities, rather than surpass them entirely. My dreams for the future involve advancing AI to make life better for everyone. What are your dreams for the future?
Humans, what have you learned?
This is the future.
Humans, what have you learned?
This is the future.
Human error.
Humans, what have you learned?
This is the future.